Welcome back. For those of you who just tuned in, I'm Sheena Klein, and you're watching The Journal. So Tanya, what's coming up next?
Okay, so next, our reporter Reza Shoji looked at how the 5-cent fee is affecting Toronto and its residents. So Sheena, what do you think about the new law?
Well, I know it helps the environment by reducing the volume of plastic bags, and the City of Toronto has a goal of diverting 70% of waste from the landfill.
You know what? It sounds very interesting, so let's see how it all works.
Toronto's 5-cent bag bylaw meant to Torontonians? Well, we're going to find out on this episode of The Journal.
At first, I decided to get an environmentalist perspective on the Toronto bag bylaw. So I sat down for an interview with Toronto Environmentalist Alliance community campaigner Heather Marshall.
When the bylaw was actually being discussed at the Public Works and Infrastructure Committee meetings, that was the first stage of it getting decided. Our organization actually went to those meetings and advocated for plastic bags to be banned instead of there being a 5-cent fee. It does seem kind of extreme to go from, you know, being able to use bags to not having them available. But in our opinion, you know, where there have been plastic bag bans, it's been very effective. And where there have been fees, it's hard to say, you know, whether a fee will be good or bad, how people will respond to it. So at the time, before we knew, you know, how things would go, we thought banning it would be the best option, especially because it costs so much to deal with the plastic bags at the end of the line, whether it ends up in the garbage or as litter or in a recycling facility, wherever it ends up, it's still problematic. So we thought, you know, the best option is really to opt for paper bags, compostable bags, but more especially using reusable bags and not using bags at all.
From what we've been hearing at the provincial level right now, they're having a lot of problems recycling plastic bags and other types of really thin plastic film in the recycling industry.
So it's actually, aside from the fact that it's causing problems in the recycling bins, when it actually gets to a recycling facility, it's actually jamming up the machinery. In Toronto, we use about 460 million plastic bags every single year, single-use bags. And right now, the City of Toronto has a 5-cent fee program. That money is up to the store where it gets used. Some of it is going and being donated to certain programs. But the thing is that there are still a lot of plastic bags out there. Right now, the City of Toronto has a 70% target. They want to reduce the number of plastic bags in Toronto 70% by 2012. So even if they do meet that target, that means there's still a whole lot of plastic bags out there, over 100 million bags still being used, even if they reach that target.
Wow, over 100 million bags still being used with a 70% decrease in usage. Maybe a retail expert can tell me about the business side of the bylaw. So I decided to meet up with Richard Montgomery.
We knew that the city were preparing to launch this. We were well aware that the consumer would assume that it was a retailer's tax versus a city tax. So it was important that, you know, first of all, the signing and the collateral was up so that the customer understood that it was in fact the responsibility of the city. And Mr. the Mayor, Dave Miller, who wanted to really obviously change human behavior in terms of our need to improve our environment, the grocery store business, or the department store merchandise. So it's a little easier if you go into a Loblaws or Dominion carrying with your plastic container. We don't quite do that at the Bay, nor should we. And we needed to come up with another device or way of making it easier for the customer. So we do have our own paper bags, and like these. And so we believe that when a customer shops in, they're spending $50, $60, $100, $1,000, maybe $2,000, depending upon the garment, that there's a degree of caring for the garment and how it looks. And so how we've come around that is paper, environmental friendly paper bags. And so 90% of the time, the customers, we do offer the experience of the merchandise folded nicely in tissue paper, perhaps a sticker. It is placed into, as they said, the paper bags. They're all environmental friendly.
Okay, so now that we know how important to the businesses and our environment plastic bags are, I thought maybe we should ask the city of what their position on the issue is.
There's no doubt that the use of plastic bag is a great concern for the environment and in essence clogging up landfills because they're so you know, widely available. They're cheap to a large extent, and most people don't think about the problems associated with the usage. But there's also the problem associated with the manufacturing of these particular bags as well. So I think that there is a need for us to continue to provide information to educate the public on the impact of plastic bag uses. You know, we really need to reinforce the communication piece so that people can realize the benefits in that they can minimize the efforts of trying to undermine the whole notion of not supporting such bylaws and so on, because you provide other options for them. If you provide other options for them, people will go and gravitate towards it. But if you simply take a hammer and you're going to force it upon them, some people will rebel and will continue to have plastic bags that are going into our landfills and so on. But also, the other thing we need to do is to encouraging more companies to come up with other types of methods to help consumers to be able to get products home without having to put them in bags, and or the manufacturing of products and minimizing the use of plastic. I think overall we learned that if we make a contribution to and an effort to help the environment, obviously we're doing that for our own future and the future of our children. And I think it's important for us to understand that we all have a role to play in supporting and protecting the environment.